All right, welcome back, everybody. This is XO Tactical, and today we're going to be talking about self-defense, more specifically, self-defense ammo. So today we're going to be talking about our self-defense gun. This is my Sig Sauer P320 RXP. It is clear. It is unloaded for YouTube, so you guys can see. This P320, we have it equipped with our Olight PL Mini Valkyrie 2 weapons light, the Romeo 1 Pro, handle it grips, which is a great little upgrade for it. And we got night sight suppressor, height sights, flat trigger, excellent self-defense gun. This little red dot is quite the red dot, very nice. All is SIG, backed by its warranty, excellent firearm. If you haven't seen a review on this, make sure to check on the link up here. It'll take you to that video. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into it. So now that I've shared it, this is my home defense gun. There is certain ammo that I try to keep in this particular firearm. And today we'll be discussing a little bit of, you know, why you would choose self-defense, or if you are using full metal jacket or training rounds, what's the difference? Why is one cheaper? Why is one more expensive? And overall, there's so many different self-defense rounds, which would be the right fit for you. We'll discuss a little bit about that. Again, remember, if you're local to Florida, especially in the Hollywood area, don't forget to go visit the guys at Rules of Engravement. Eddie and the guys over there have continued to say that if you guys go over there, let them know that Max from XL Tactical sent you. They'll pass on the savings to you guys. I'll link their information and right here, some of the stuff that you can see on their Instagram page. Plus, I'll get their information down below. But let's get right into this video. So out of the rounds that we have here, this is the jacketed hollow point. From what you see, it's a full bullet, full lead casing. This is really considered more the training round. Less price to manufacture and definitely cheaper to shoot. So typically this is the round that we're gonna be taking more to the range and is recommended to the range. You'll find this for about 15, 17 around pre-pandemic. Hopefully they can go back down to that pricing. So the rest of the rounds that you see there are more hollow points, different grains, 115, there's 127, the 147 grain, and this one is the Hornady Critical Defense. Grain will be a little bit more gunpowder. I feel that sometimes higher grain actually shoots a little bit softer. Every shooter is a little bit different, but those are the different types of rounds that we have here. We have different manufacturers that make these. The major difference between both rounds, as you see there, one has a hollow point and one is just full casing. Now, what does that do? The hollow point, upon impact, it expands and it creates a flowering mushroom type of expansion. And what does that usually do? It's basically like a punch. It's like a stopping power. Now, different rounds will expand different, more stopping power. You can check, depending on the round that you are gonna want to carry, if you're choosing some of these self-defense ammo, you can look up ballistics tests and how they react. You'll be surprised to see what it does. Again, let's say this goes to a target. Now, the expansion creates the power, that punch per se, right? And it also expands the cavity. So what it also does is damage, maximum damage. Consider this, when it goes through, it's just gonna make a hole and keep penetrating. This creates a bigger hole because it's mushroomed and it creates a devastating cavity, which again, stopping power and does what it's supposed to do, which is ultimately stop the threat. When choosing any of the self-defense ammo, know what limitations your gun can do. If you don't, you can have malfunctions that you're creating. Perfect example here. So I've shot my AKV. You guys have seen me shoot my AKV plenty of times. I'm gonna put here a video of what happened with this particular circumstance. Hmm. it wasn't until after the fact that I realized that it isn't recommended and certain ammo isn't recommended. Now my AKV should be able to shoot plus P self-defense, and that wasn't the type that I was shooting. So this was a malfunction that I created for myself. It could have been much, much worse. So I recommend that you guys stay informed of what self-defense ammo can be recommended for the firearm that you're gonna be using it in. So these are all great rounds. Again, if you wanna use this as a self-defense round, nothing is saying that you cannot use it. There's no problem with using it. Just understand what the difference is. It's much cheaper to shoot this one, but it does have that extra penetration and not so much the stopping power. These particular rounds, you can YouTube it, you can Google it. You'll see images and videos out there of what this does to that particular threat. There's ballistic gels that they shoot with this, and you'll see not only the cavity that it creates upon entry and how much travel it has. So if it would be going through a threat, it's creating a cavity, which creates damage, right? Maximum damage, but you're not running the risk of it over penetrating. And again, like I said, finding another possible target, which is always very critical when you're using this. So in these day and ages right now, whatever pricing you're finding is kind of going to be different. I've actually found that some of the self-defense is only a couple bucks more than a training ammo right now. So if you can find it, you know, pick it up. Just make sure that you're staying informed with what is recommended for your type of firearm, whether you're running it through a handgun, your PCC, different firearms, different recommendations. But ensure that you are, like I said, training with it so you know what that round feels like, how it reacts, how it's gonna shoot in your hands, and that you know that when you're ever gonna pull that firearm and use it in a self-defense scenario, that you're prepared for that. Let me know in the comments section, what's your favorite round, which is the round that you choose to pick. Did I miss a particular round that we didn't discuss here? I'd like to know what your thoughts are on that as well. Again, if you like these videos, make sure to like, comment, and share. And if you haven't subscribed, consider doing it if we're doing a good job here. But until next time, I'll see you guys later.